Good morning, students. In this video session, I am going to teach about self-referential structures. In the previous classes, I taught various different structures, right? Like what is structures and what is nested structures. And in this video session, we are going to see about self-referential structures. What is self-referential structures? Self-referential structures are structures that have one or more pointers of the same type of structure as your member. That means in the self-referential structure, in all the structures, there are various members are there, right? Self-referential structures means it has one pointer data member in the of same type of structure. That is, the self-referential structures has one pointer variable as the member. That's it. Easily, if you want to understand means, self-referential structure means inside that one pointer variable acts as your member. See this example, struct node is the structure name. Here one value, okay. And see here, self-referential structure means it has one pointer variable. I told it has one pointer variable. See here, this nest is the pointer variable. So one structure member is the pointer, which belongs to which type? See, the same node, okay. So the same type of structure which is pointing the pointer here. Okay, that is called as self-referential structure. It is nothing but inside the structure, one pointer should be there. It belongs to the same structure data. Okay. So this self-referential structure is the basic for all the data structures. In the further semesters, we will study the data structures. That one concept is the linked list. With the help of this referential structure only, you are going to construct the linked list. Okay, so I will explain with one example so it is easy to understand for you. So see here, this is the linked list. But linked list means, consider this is one node, these three boxes is one node. Okay, two data values are there, right? So in this node, two datas are there and one link is there. Link is nothing but a pointer which holds the address of another node. What is pointer? Pointer means it holds the address of another variable. So here one link. This link holds the address of another variable. So here two nodes are there. One is object one and another one is object two. Inside the object one, two datas and one link is there. This link is holding the address of another node, this starting address. And this X denotes null. Null means empty. From there, the linked list got ended. Okay. So linked list is nothing but like that. Many nodes are there. It should be interconnected with the links. At the end of the linked list, there is a X symbol. That is, we can say it is a null. All of you understood? Now see this example. First, I am creating one structure. I am going to create one node. Okay. Struct node. Here how many datas are there? Two data. So int data 1, char data 2. Two datas I am going to construct here. Okay. Then struct node link. What is this? Self-referential structure. Self-referential structure means it has one pointer which belongs to the same data. Struct node link. So this is the self-referential structure. I declared this structure above the main. Okay. Now inside the main, I am creating the structure variable. What is this OB1? It is a structure variable for this node. Okay. So using this OB1 only, we can able to access this data. What's the use of structure variable? Using this structure variable only, we can able to access each and every data members in the structure. And one more thing, once you declare the structure variable only, the memory will be assigned here. Okay, got it. Now, I am initializing here, I am initializing the values for the structure data members. For data 1, I am allocating value 10. For data 2, I am allocating 20. Why you are using OB1 here? OB1 is structure variable dot, accessing operator is dot, data 1 equal to 10. Structure variable dot data 2 equal to 1. At first, I am making this position as null. That's what object link equal to null. I have not created the second node. So at first I am making this position as null. That's what object 1.link equal to null. Now I am going to create the another node, this ob2 node. So struct node ob2, it's another structure variable. Struct node is the structure name, ob2 is the structure variable, second structure variable. Using this, I am going to create the another node. So in this node, using this ob2, I am accessing, separate memory was allocated for ob2. ob2.data1, I am allocating value 30. ob2.data2, I am allocating the value as 40. Now, I am making this as null. Why I am making this as null means, I am going to interconnect to, I am going to link these two nodes. So I am making this as null first. Okay. Now I am going to link both the nodes. For linking, here the object 1.link. I am going to link the second object, this node. I am going to link this second node with the first node link, right? So object1.link, this position. Object1.link equal to address of ob2. So the starting address of ob2 was accessed here. Now using this link, I can able to access all the data values here. See here, printf %d ob1, that is object1, this first node link, this link dot data1 means you can access this 30. Then ob1 object1 dot link data2 means you are accessing this 40. Why you are accessing this? Already this object2 is allocated, object2 memory, this node starting memory is allocated here. That's what you are getting the output, and 30 and 40. What is self-referencing structure? It is nothing but it has one member as pointer which denotes the same data type. It is known as self-referential structure. Thank you, students.